everything should be covered a bit more concisely, for the reasons that I don't really want to spend more than 10 minutes talking about Mono. I think it's just going to be against the interest of trying to make this video useful enough. So, just going through the final important bit about Mono. So, it's based on very bad technology. We see what happened with .NET on the internet. Based on merits, it's basically losing to the competition, mostly to LAMP servers based on Linux at the lower level, and usually using something like PHP at the top. So they don't actually use .NET. And if you look at the world's biggest companies, even those who are partners of Microsoft, don't want to use .NET to do the net management and run servers. So they haven't been very successful at that. So why would you want to then replace in free software something like a Java server or say, I'm trying to think of Python even. You know, Google's doing extremely well without depending on any of that sort of mess. And recently, in fact, it's interesting that Attachmate was firing all the staff of Mono, which I think is a very telling situation. They didn't really see the value in trying to encourage the development of something which hasn't worked after many years of developing in Novell and hasn't really caught on for even technical reasons. So, just to summarize, then we have the issue of control. Microsoft is actually benefiting from the fact that the free software developers will be very much confused and associated and obsessed with something like the APIs of Microsoft. Then there will be the patent threats on top of that. So even if they were, even if many developers were embracing the Microsoft APIs and were doing pretty well with Microsoft, could sue. And finally, I mean, why would you want to use it in the first place? It's not as though we don't have enough languages. It's not as though we don't have any, decent API and decent performance. It's just emulating bad systems, which tend to crash a lot, and maybe easier to develop for in some ways. Usually if you use Windows and like Visual Studio, but from a Linux point of view, almost no reason. You can use Wine if you want to run Windows programs written in .NET, but you don't actually have to like try and bring development from Windows to Linux and work with the Microsoft rules, and I think that pretty much summarizes the series of videos as far as I can tell.